A nucleus is a very tiny part of the atom, which is already very, very small and can't be seen with the naked eye. So how do we know it exists? Previously, I have talked about how we know electrons exist, which is a negatively charged particle. Since atoms are stable, after we discovered the electron, it was proposed that the atom must have a positive charge to balance the negative from the electron. And Thomson had proposed this model, where an atom is a positive charge background with a negative electrons embedded in it. This inspired the name of the model, and it was called the plum pudding model for the atom, resembling the traditional English dessert, the plum pudding. Interestingly, it took one of Thomson's own students to disprove the plum pudding model for a better understanding of the atom. This was done by the great experimentalist Ernest Rutherford, who published this paper which demolished the plum pudding model in 1911. Rutherford and his colleagues Giger and Marsden tested this model for the atom with the following setup. Rutherford had a material that shines when it's hit by a positive charge, something like a screen, and he set it up in this fashion. Then he had a device that would shoot positive charges called alpha particle. So if an alpha particle is shot, it would shine the material here. Then he placed a really thin gold foil, kind of like tin foil but it's made of gold, right here in the middle. And he shot the positive alpha particles to see what would happen. Most of the time, the positive alpha particles would go through the atoms of the gold foil and flash behind the foil, right here on the screen. But other times, he got impressions here, 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 in different places, and in fact, at times, it was a straight deflection right back. Let's zoom in the gold foil to see what could be happening. The alpha particles were going through the foil, but sometimes deflected in this way or this way. Based on that, Rutherford understood that the atoms are mostly empty space and not a pudding-like positive bed of matter. Rutherford expected this to happen, as he thought the positive bed in the plum pudding model is thin and a speeding alpha particle can pierce straight through it anyway. But what about the other cases where the particles deflect or even return? Deflection of the alpha particle is caused by either repulsion from the positive alpha particle with the positive charge in the atom that we spoke about earlier, or collision, as the particles were hitting something inside the atom and hence being deflected, sometimes right back 180 degrees, which is remarkable. Based on these results, Rutherford proposed that the positive charge in the atom is very small and condensed, and it makes most of the mass of the atom because the rest of the atom is empty space, and that's why he got these results. He then proposed this model of the atom, which replaced the plum pudding model. The center part that's positive and was interacting with the alpha particles is really the nucleus, and this is how it was discovered by Rutherford, and the Rutherford model replaced the plum pudding description of an atom.